Assalamu alaikum. Dear my friends, dear my students. Today I'd like to talk with you about chapter 9, using verbs correctly. In this chapter, you should know the principal parts of the verb, regular verb and irregular verb, the tense, the voice, and troublesome verbs. At the very beginning, you know that okay, the verb has four types, or four parts, four principal parts. It means past form or present, like stop or stops, present participle, verb plus ing, we have helping verb plus ing. Past means verb too, like stop, and maybe the regular verb like went. Past participle, we have, as I told you, 3H, have, has, had, and verb 3, like stopped or gone. Okay? This is about the principal parts of the verb. Like here, this example, number one, I, and the DDK to use K present or past participle. Okay, our base form, we know it. I every day, and it is base form, means I, for example, for the verb work, I work every day. Present participle, I am working every day now. I need it past, I work it. I work it every day last week. For past participle, I have worked it every day since August. Okay, don't forget that for regular verbs, we should memorize, and we didn't have a rule for it. We just memorize the regular verb, like ring, rang, rung, but don't use rung by itself. It should be used with 3H, as I told you, have, has, had. This is the most important point. We talk about its verb tense. The tense of the verb has six types, as you know, present, past, future, present perfect, past perfect, future perfect. When you talk about the past tense, means you talk about action that happened in the past and finished already. Action finished completely. I wrote a story last week. I played outside during recess. I stopped the car suddenly when the dog ran into the road. Present tense, you talk about something that is repeated or happened, you know. Like I write stories all the time in the class. This time I'm talking about my habit. I play outside during recess. This is also a regular action. I stop the car when I see animals run into the road. This is now. Okay. Future, you talk about something that will happen in the future. Expecting it, promise, threat, offer. I will write story next week. This is why I'm expecting to do. I will play outside during recess today. I'm thinking I'm going to do this one. I will stop the car if I see this. Okay. In case this one happened, this conditional. Here we have she walked, this past. Timothy swims, this present. I will start, this what future. The best perfect, you choose it specially or you write it when you are gonna talk about two actions, one happened first and one happened after it. The one happened first is best perfect. The one followed it is best simple, like this one. By the time the class had ended, this happened first. Jamal had recited. This, okay, followed it directly. Okay, part of the poem. Present perfect, we use especially when an event begins in the past and continues to or ends in the present, just finished now. Formed by adding what have or has plus past participle. Hungry crocodile has eaten the rabbit. Hungry crocodile singular, we use has, helping verb, and verb 3 after it. Future perfect means you use will, have, arrived, and this one talking about action that will be finished in the future before another one. Now we have had, reached, past perfect, will have, grown, this future perfect, has skinned, this present perfect. Something related to constancy of the verb or the constancy of the tense. If you start with present, complete with present. If you start with the best, complete in the best. Here it is inconsistent. Why? You started in the best where, and it changes to be begin, should be begin. If we start with are, it should be what? Begin. The same tense, we don't change it. Now I need to move with you to the voice, but it's better to look it from another part. I created this one for you. Look at me now. Number one, present tense, we use it especially with repeated action or facts. Repeated actions or facts, like Peter writes a novel yearly. This is his habit. The form of this verb is the tense, subject, plus verb with S or no S. That's okay, then you complete with the object. Okay, طب if it is passive voice, how I make it? Two things you didn't know. Use verb to be and verb 3. You start with the object, then am is are plus verb 3. A novel is written yearly by Peter. Number 2, best symbol. Action finished in a specific time. Nothing finished in the past. Peter wrote a novel yesterday. Here we have subject plus verb 2. As we mentioned it before, it's best. Here, how to make it passive. Start with object, then was or were, and verb 3. A novel was written yesterday by Peter. For future symbol, it is used especially when you offer something, you okay, promise or a threat or a prediction. Peter will write a novel soon. Okay, the form of it, subject plus will plus infinitive. Okay, when you make it passive voice, use object plus will be plus verb 3. A novel will be written soon by Peter. For present perfect, we use it as an action that just finished, or action started in the past and still existed, or action finished but not known when. Okay, you didn't know when it happened. When you say, I have tried sushi before, but you didn't remember when you tried it. Peter has written a novel before. To make it passive voice, this is its form, subject plus has or have plus verb 3. But to make it passive voice, make it object, have or has, according to the okay, the object, singular or plural, then been plus what, verb plus, okay, plus what, verb 3. A novel has been written before by Peter. For past perfect, we use an action finished first before another action. Okay, we call it oldest event. Peter had written a novel for many years. This means action that just finished for a long time ago. Subject plus had, this is the form, plus verb 3. To make it passive voice, starts with object, and then had, then been, plus verb 3. A novel had been written for many years by Peter. For future perfect, we use especially when an action will be finished before another action, but in the future. Like what? Peter will have written a novel by 2026. Before 2026, Peter will finish his novel. Before this time come, he's going to finish it. Maybe he's going to finish 2025, 24, but before this time, he's going to finish it. The form of it in the active voice, subject plus will plus have plus verb 3. To make it passive voice, start with object, and then we'll have been plus verb 3. So it's going to be what? A novel will have been written by 2026 by Peter. So you have verb to be that it must be used in the tense. It means use number 1, as I told you before, use verb to be, use object. Okay. Then after use object, use verb to be according to the tense. And then use verb 3, its past participle. Okay, you can add by, then the agent means the subject again, but we didn't need it, especially in the passive voice, because maybe the subject is very known and we didn't need to say it. Maybe the subject is unimportant and okay, we didn't need to know it, or it's what vague for us, so we didn't need to use it.